In this video, let's see how to evaluate the integral of tan cube x and the integration is from 0 to pi by 4. This question is in your NCERT books and was asked in the CBSE examination, year was 2004. So if my given question is say I, then how to go about it? I'm going to teach you that. I have written solution. Let's start with it. Let me write the question again. I is equal to 0 to pi by 4. Tan cube x. Now tan cube x can be written in the next step as tan x multiply tan square x. So I write 0 to pi by 4 tan x multiply tan square x dx. Now see, tan square x directly I cannot evaluate it, but I know that tan square x is equal to secant square x minus 1, that I can use. So, I write 0 to pi by 4 tan x multiply by secant square x minus 1. And that whole will come in the bracket. Why I have done this is important because secant square x minus tan square x is equal to 1. Now, let me open the bracket. So, it is 0 to pi by 4 tan x secant square x dx. Because the limits are there. So, next time also when I open up the brackets, so with tan x also along with dx the limits should come. Now I know that if I put tan x as t, then secant square x dx is dt. That means substitution can work here. So I will be going by substitution. If this is my I1 integration that I need to take up first and this is my I2, then individually now I can write I is equal to I1 minus I2. Now let me evaluate I1. Now for I1 what I am going to do, let tan x is equal to t, that means secant square x dx is equal to dt. So what is my I1? My I1 can be evaluated as dt is here, t is here, so t and integration. Now the limits would change because here it is 0 to pi by 4 when x is equal to 0. When x is equal to 0, tan 0 is 0, so 0 only. When x is equal to pi by 4, tan pi by 4 is 1. So it should be t square by 2 and 0 to 1. So it is nothing but 1 by 2 because earlier I am going to put 1 then 0. So it is 1 by 2. Next I would be seeing that yes, I know that I1 has been evaluated. But my question is still not complete because I am left with my I2. Let me write I2 again. It is integration tan x dx 0 to pi by 4. Now what is integration of tan x? It is minus log cos x or log sec x. So I write log sec x. And if it is log sec x, directly I can go about putting the limits because I didn't substitute this time. Now it should be log sec pi by 4 minus log sec 0, right? So what is log sec pi by 4? Log sec pi by 4 would be log under root 2 minus 0, which is only log under root 2. So see, the answer to I1 evaluated, the answer to I2 evaluated. Now what is my I? If I put equation number 1, I know that from 1, my I is equal to I1 minus I2, that means 1 by 2 minus log under root 2, and that should be the answer to this question.